I have von Hippel-Lindau, which is a rare genetic form of cancer. I've been in a protocol here for about 19 years. And then I just found out today my kidney tumor has grown, so I'll have to have kidney surgery within the next few months, probably this summer.
In the early 1980s, we wanted to develop better therapies for kidney cancer. And the approach we took was by identifying the genes for kidney cancer. When we started, we thought kidney cancer was a single disease. We treated them all the same way surgically. We treated advanced disease all the same way with drugs, with medicines, none of which worked. What we've learned over the years is that kidney cancer is not a single disease. It's a number of different types of cancers that just happen to occur in the kidney. They have different histologies. They look different under the microscope. They have different clinical course. Some grow very slow and are indolent. Others are very aggressive and can spread very quickly. And they all respond differently to therapy. And as we've come to know, they are caused by different genes. So our approach to identifying the genes that cause kidney cancer and in developing therapies for kidney cancer has been in studying the families that in which kidney cancer runs. There's no place that I know like the NIH Intramural Program as far as people being incentivized to work together. So for example, I work on our kidney cancer program, I work with over 140 scientists from 29 different labs and branches from 7 different institutes. At many other places where I could work, that would just be hard to do. But here, it's easy to do. It's incentivized. It's encouraged. In other words, my belief is we're never going to make progress working by ourselves, and that team science is the way to make progress today in science. And what we do has a lot of complexities. We take care of patients. We do very careful phenotype analysis to determine what manifestations they have, what kind of tumors they have. That takes an enormous effort, but a lot of very committed nurses and physicians and scientists. And then we study the genes that cause these cancers, and understanding those and how they work take a lot of people working together. So there's no other place I can think of where someone like me would have been able to do this kind of work all these years.
Everybody here is so friendly and helpful. I mean, and like I said, we've been coming here 19 years, and I mean, honestly, I don't think there's really ever been a terrible experience. Everybody's just, you know, because it is so big, everybody's willing to help and point in the right direction if you look lost, and, you know, answer questions that you might have, that sort of thing, for as big as it is.
This is the XF96 extracellular flux analyzer. What this machine does is it is a remarkably powerful machine for understanding metabolic flux, so we're studying the metabolic basis of kidney cancer, and what this equipment will allow us to do is to do things like evaluate oxygen uptake and evaluate glycolysis or evaluate lactate production, which is a surrogate for glycolysis. So we have some kidney cancers that are very, very aggressive, and those cancers are characterized by mutation of a Krebs cycle enzyme called fumarate hydratase. When we run those cancers on this machine, we can see they're taking up almost no oxygen. Oxidative phosphorylation, in other words, the cell is breathing, is way down in those cells, and their glycolysis is way up. And we can measure that on this machine. So then we take another type of kidney cancer called clear cell kidney cancer, which is characterized by mutation of the VHL gene. Those cells are very different. Their metabolic makeup is extremely different. They're breathing normally. They're taking up oxygen normally, and they're not doing nearly as much glycolysis. They're not taking up very much glucose at all. So there's two very different types of cancers, and we treat them in very, very different ways. So this lets us analyze, develop the metabolic profile of these cancer cell lines, and also helps us evaluate response to therapy. We can put certain therapies in there and see how that'll affect the metabolic pathways. So it's really a remarkable instrument. What we found by studying these and other types of kidney cancer is if we look at all the genes that are known to cause kidney cancer, which there are about 16 of those genes, that kidney cancer is, as I say, fundamentally a metabolic disease. And each of these genes affects the cell's ability to sense changes in oxygen, iron, nutrients, or energy. So kidney cancer is fundamentally metabolic. And the main approach we are working on is targeting the metabolic basis of this cancer. We're very, very encouraged by the results that we've seen, and we're hopeful that this will provide the foundation for the development of effective forms of therapy for all forms of kidney cancer.